Welcome to the second part of the lecture. So we were talking about the testing fundamentals. The testing fundamentals indicate that there are three conditions. Now there are two numbers, calculated value and the tabulated value. So there are three possibilities. The calculated value will be less than the tabulated value. Calculated value can be equal to the tabulated value. And the calculated value can be greater than the tabulated value. So in case, you can see the first picture, the calculated value will be the less than the tabulated value, and therefore there is no difference. If the calculated value equal to the tabulated value, then I will say at this particular level of significance, I am not sure if there is any difference. If the calculated value is greater than the tabulated value, then I will say at this particular level of significance, I will have to reject H0. I'll have to say that there is difference. Okay. So let us begin with the concept of a chi-square test. It is chi is a Greek letter, and the concept of a chi-square test, and the formula is given on the screen. Okay. So there is something called a degree of freedom in the chi-square test. Degree of freedom means it has to do with the number of outcomes in the particular experiment, number of possible outcomes. So for example, if I have a coin, so it is known that a coin will have two possible outcomes. So therefore, in that case, the coin has 1 degree of freedom. This experiment has 1 degree of freedom. If I have a die has 6 faces, number of possible outcomes are 6, and therefore in that experiment, the degree of freedom will be 1 less than the number of possible outcomes, it will be 6. Again, if I am comparing 4 health drinks, then the number of possible outcomes here is 4, and therefore the degree of freedom is 3 here. So please understand that when we are talking about degree of freedom, it is 1 less than the number of possible outcomes. Okay. So the formula for the chi-square statistic is given as this, and the statistic follows the chi-square distribution. So I am going to compare the value of the statistic with the chi-square distribution. That is what we are going to do. When do I use a chi-square test? I am going to use the chi-square test only when I am going to see whether a particular experiment or the data obtained from a particular experiment follows a particular mathematical or statistical model. So when the model of the system is known a priori, then I am going to use the chi-square test. For example, if I am talking about a nuclear reactor, we know that the nuclear fission follows the exponential distribution. So therefore, I am going to see whether my data fits the exponential distribution by using the chi-square test. Okay. If I am talking about a die, then I know that the die follows the uniform distribution. All the faces have equal probability of occurrence, and therefore I am going to compare whether my outcomes follow the uniform distribution. Okay. Now, why is this particular doubt arising? The doubt is arising because it might happen that when you are doing say 600 tosses of the die, it is expected that you will get 100 ones, 100 twos, 100 threes, 100 fours, 100 fives, and 100 sixes. But when you do the experiment in actual, it does not happen. It might be happening that the total number of outcomes are 600. Yes, total number of the tosses are 600. Of course, yes. But the frequency of 1, 2, 3, and 4, they are not the same. So does it imply that my die is biased? Does it imply? So the null hypothesis is the die is not biased. the alternate hypothesis is that I is biased. So that is why we are going to do the chi-square test, and we are going to check whether the data of the experiment follows a particular distribution or not. That is what we are going to do. So we are going to illustrate this by a particular example. So we must have heard of this guy called Gregor Mendel, and Gregor Mendel is famous for the theory of heredity, and he has proposed that the numbers should be in the proportion of 9:3:3:1. So please understand, so he did a particular experiment with peas, of course, and then he actually crossbred peas. Okay, so based on this crossbreeding experiment that he did, he found that 315 were round and yellow, 108 were round and green, 101 were wrinkled and yellow, and 32 were wrinkled and green. All right, so the 9331, does it follow the 9331? You will say by looking at the data, it doesn't. Okay, so do I have to doubt his theory at the 0.01? 0.01 means 1%, and 0.05 means 5%. So do I have to doubt his theory at 0.01 and 0.05 significance levels? That is what we are going to test by using the chi-square test. Okay, so my null hypothesis is it follows the theory, and the alternate hypothesis, of course, will be it will not follow the theory. So the theory says 9:3:3:1. So there are how many possible things? There are four possible outcomes. Please understand, the round and yellow, round and green, wrinkled and yellow, wrinkled and green. Four possible outcomes, and therefore the degree of freedom here in this particular experiment is 3. Alright? The probability of each outcome, it is 9/16, 3/16, 3/16, and 1/16, as you can see here. And therefore, we can calculate, we can multiply this probability with the number of experiments that is done. The total number of p's here is 556. So I'm going to multiply this probability into 556. So I multiply 9/16 into 556, and therefore I get an estimate, the experimental value. Please understand that 312.75 cannot be actual count of the p's, because it's not possible. The count is always 1, 2, 3, 4. We can never get a count in decimals. So the observed outcomes is 315, the expected value is 312. Observed outcome is 108, expected value is 104. So observed value is 101, but the expected value is 104. So observed value is 32 and expected value is 34.75. So what we are going to do is calculate these differences, OI minus EI, and then you actually calculate XI. The XI is in each term, this OI minus EI whole square divided by OI. So I calculate this and then finally calculate this value of X. So what I observe from this is the theoretical value at alpha equal to 0.01. I can look at the table and I can say the theoretical value is 111.3. The theoretical tables are given, please remember that. And the degree of freedom of this experiment is 3, as I told you earlier. So I am going to see and I am going to look at the chi-square table for alpha equal to 0.01 and degree of freedom equal to 3. I am going to do that. There will be cross table, and then I will see that the tabulated theoretical value is 11.3. But the calculated value of X is 0.4699. So what did we learn previously from this particular, from the previous lecture? We remember that if the calculated value is less than the tabulated value, we have to accept the null hypothesis. That is what we studied earlier. And so therefore, we can see that the calculated value is 0.4699, and it is less than the tabulated value, and therefore I have to accept the null hypothesis and says, look, the experiment is following what Mendel's theory said. Similarly, at 0.05 also, the theoretical value is 7.81, calculated value is less than the theoretical value. I'll have to say, even at 0.05 significance, I'll say it follows the Mendel's theory. That is the end of the second part of the lecture.